Hi, my name is Shannon Rainville.
And I'm Cynthia Romano.
And we are two out of the four Timberlane player leaders. And tonight, we would like to welcome our Timberlane Passions Project, previously known as Art Night. We have 13 very talented groups performing with us, and there will be actually 16 acts, and you'll see anything from dancing to singing to improv. Enjoy! Up, we have the other two Timberlane player leaders, Hadisha Miller and Beth Hughes, performing The Girl from Ipanema with Galen, Mason, and Nora.
Tall and tan and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes, each when she passes goes, oh. When she walks, she's like a samba that sways so cool and swings so gentle that when she passes, each when she passes goes, oh. But I watch her so sadly. How can I tell her I love her? Yes, I would give my heart gladly. To the scene, she looks straight ahead, not at me. Tall and tan and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes, I smile, but she doesn't see.
Olha que coisa mais linda, mais cheia de graça. Ela, menina que vem aqui passa, no doce balança, caminho do mar. A moça do corpo dourado, do sol de Ipanema. Eu sei balançado, parece um poema. A coisa mais linda que eu já vi passar.
Oh, but I watch her so sadly.
Ai, porque tudo é tão triste.
Yes, I would give my heart gladly. Each day when she walks through the sea, she looks straight ahead, not at me. Tall, tan, young, and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes, I smile, but she doesn't see.
Por causa do amor,
she just doesn't see.
Nem olha pra mim,
she never sees me.
Causa do amor.
Next up, we have Ian Macomer, Max Oreo, Evan Casey, and Jason Casey singing For the Longest Time in a barbershop quartet. Enjoy.
Dum, dum, dum. For the longest time, whoa,
longest
for the longest.
If you said goodbye to me tonight, there would still be music left to write. What else could I do? I'm so inspired by you. This hasn't happened for the longest time. Once I thought my innocence was gone. Ooh. Now I know that happiness goes on. That's where you found me. When you put your arms around me. This hasn't happened for the longest time.
Whoa.
Longest
for the longest time. Whoa.
For the longest, I'm that voice you're hearing in the hall.
Ooh.
And the greatest miracle of all is how I need you and how you needed me too. This hasn't happened for the longest time. Maybe this this won't last very long. You feel so right, and I could be wrong. Maybe I've been hoping too hard, but I've gone this far, and it's more than I hoped for. Who knows how much further we'll go on? Maybe I'll be sorry when you're gone. I'll take my chances. I forgot how nice romance is. This hasn't happened for the longest time. Had second thoughts at the start. I said to myself, hold on to your heart. Now I know the woman that you are. You're wonderful so far, and it's more than I hoped for. Who knows how much further we'll go on? I have been a fool for lesser things. I want you so bad. I think you ought to know that I intend to hold you for the longest time. Whoa, for the longest time. Whoa, longest for the longest time. Whoa, longest for the longest time. Whoa, longest for the longest time.
Hello, hello, one and all. Mr. DeBartolomeo, do you have that special little song that I just sent you to get the people?
Here we go, yo.
Yes,
here we go,
that's
yo.
The one I'm referencing.
So what's the scenario? Here we go,
people yo. In the seats, here we go, all so what, 600 of you, please stand up now, get funky, start moving as we have a little milkman. Yeah, yeah, that's right. Here we go. That's right, we are Milkman Improv. We got Galen, we got Shannon Rainville, we got Best Hughes, we got Sean Hurley and Ash Lombard. We are Milkman Improv. I need a little call and response. When I say hey, you say oh. Hey! Hey! Hey, oh, look at this nice transition as the music fades out like we talked about 5 minutes ago, Mr. DeBartolomeo. Look at that, very seamless. We're gonna play some improv games for you very quickly. This one's called Reverse Trivial Pursuit. If I ask you for a handle, you're gonna throw me an interesting noun. And like the game Jeopardy, the milkmen are going to ask a Jeopardy-like question. We'll start things off, noun. Irish soap, not just any soap, Irish soap.
What is secretly made of potatoes?
I gotta get clean.
What Scottish people use?
Ooh. What is the greenest soap on the market?
Dove. Noun. Suit.
What is Galen so fashionably dressed in?
Ooh.
What doesn't fit on my forearms?
What sounds like soup?
Thank you. Noun. There is no wrong answer. Oh, CC Costa. Who is not CC Romano?
What is better than C. Ka?
Noun. Sock.
What sounds like soap?
What is the acoustic version of a shoe?
What do I put on my hands before I go to sleep?
What sounds like a swear wearing a mask?
What never comes in trios.
That's also true. All right, one more.
Rubber duck.
What is just taxidermy done wrong?
What is actually an invasive species? Bet you didn't know that.
What do I keep next to my Irish soap?
What do I keep under my pillow at night?
And scene. All right, that was awesome. We're going to play another game for you. We want some, this is kind of like a serious thing though, so if you guys can kind of just change your moods for a second. We're going to play a game called Intellectual Coffee House for Beatnik Poets. The Milkies have kind of been working on some poetry. They're trying to hone their poetry craft. These pieces are kind of really near and dear to them. So if we can do this, kind of be serious for a second, and then we can get back to some fun, awesome acts. Can you throw out a topic that's very, very meaningful, very personal? Cooking with pickles, thank you. Galen, please. The slam poem, Cooking with Pickles.
Into the cookbook, I look through the pages. For the succulent dish of cucumber ages. Surrounded by vinegar and soaking in water, the cucumber succumbs to a quick, brothy slaughter.
Oh my goodness, thank you, thank you. There was a little laughter over here, so if we could please take this seriously. Another topic of meaning? Maple syrup, please, Shannon.
Trees. Maple trees. Maple syrup trees. On pancakes? Waffles? What is next?
Thank you. Thank you. Socrates right there. Yes, please. Hockey. Yes. Please, Bess, the piece you've been working on, hockey.
Sound I hear invading my brain whenever I go near the ice. It's cold. Why are they so rough? Can we please just be friends?
Yes.
And not puck, puck, puck?
Yes, yes, thank you. The sound I always hear at hockey. And this last one, this is actually an interesting one. This is a dual piece, a back and forth, kind of a back and forth dialogue of sorts about obviously the most important topic we've had today. What was it?
Kneecaps.
Kneecaps. You tell us about the knee, you tell us about the cap. Together, we'll see what happens.
I have mine.
I have mine. We need each other.
We cap each other off.
When I ever need to knead my bread, I just right in the dough, and it's kneaded.
When I ever need to cap my drink, I just get the cap and put it on the drink.
Without the two of us together,
there would be no running.
Thank you. And once again, that was Milkman Improv. We're sorry we had to slow things down with some serious things. We'll get you back to your entertainment right now. Thank you so much, Milkman Improv. Thank you. Thank you. Have a nice night.
All right. Thank you for sharing some laughs with us. Next is going to be Cece Romano showing an audio of that she made, putting her voice together, to sing Mary, Did You Know?
Hi everyone. I've been working on a project. The song Mary Did You Know, the cover by Pentatonix, that's a song that I've really just loved for a long time. And so I decided, why not just make my own cover of it? So I learned all the parts, couldn't learn to beatbox in time, but all the percussion is just sounds that are around my house. So the video that I've made will actually be out very soon, but as of now, I just have the audio, so I would like to invite all of you to close your eyes and listen along. Thank you. And now, Lena Bonanno performing Always Remember Us This Way.
Choked up, but I can't fight the words.
every time we say goodbye, baby, it hurts. When the sun goes down and the band won't play, I'll always remember us this way. Lovers in the night, poets trying to write. We don't know how to rhyme, but damn, we try. But all I really know is where I wanna go. Every time we say goodbye, baby, it hurts. When the sun goes down and the band won't play, I'll always remember us this way. Oh, yeah. I don't want to be just a memory, baby.
Lena, that was fantastic. The world's a wacky place right now. People have a lot of questions. People need advice. And so we heard these words that you were seeking answers for, so the milkmen are back to offer some advice to you. However, we don't just have any people giving advice. We have some very important people. We have Bess, who is a waitress who feels she is overworked and underappreciated. We have Shannon, who is a very frustrated and angry librarian because no one is following any library protocol. We have Sean, who is a very frustrated football coach because he doesn't think that his team is going to be able to win the big game. We have Ash, who is a skate park instructor who is trying to help the beginners with those skating skills. And we have Galen, and Galen, this is kind of an interesting one here. You have been very overly optimistic despite impending doom. We have time to take a few questions, probably two questions. You seem like someone who needs a lot of help. Well, we don't have time to go into it. We're trying to get off the air soon. What is the issue that you have going on? What do you need advice for? Oh my goodness, lots of leftover Halloween candy, what to do with it? We'll start with waitress Bess.
So you have leftovers, huh? Leftovers? Yeah. Are you just gonna leave them all over the table? Are you just gonna leave them like a mess all over the table? No, no, you can't do that because I don't get paid enough to do that for you. So you know what you should do with your leftover Halloween candy? Take it home. Ask for a box. Take it home, please. Less for me to do, unless I leave a tip. But no one leaves a tip anymore. You know, here's a little tip for you, huh?
Don't come in with 10 people. Please, I'm begging you. That's what you should do with your Halloween candy. Just take it home, please.
Selfish. You're being selfish. Sorry about that, Bess. What do you have for us, librarian Shannon?
I think that's a very interesting question because, in my mind, if you have candy, you're more inclined to bring it to school, hand it out to your friends. And as great as that is, that'll mix in with books, and books and candy don't mix. No, they don't. Yeah, no. Also, candy makes people very noisy, and we don't allow food or noise in the library. At all. None. So no, thank you. Just throw it out. That's all.
Once again, I'm sorry about that as well. Selfish. Coach, what do you have for us?
If you have Halloween candy, throw it away. Don't even eat it, okay? We can't leave you being out of shape. We need to win this game next week. If we don't win this, we're out of the playoffs and we're done. I've coached for 30 years, haven't even won 2 games. We're in the playoffs now.
Yeah, I'm curious. How did you get in the playoffs?
You know, we're just really good this year. You know, we never lost a game before in my coaching career. And, why would you even get candy? How'd you get candy? You want Halloween? You went out for Halloween? Don't. You know, we can't risk people going down. You know, if you go out and you get COVID, this whole thing's over. My whole career is over. Okay? That's all I can. Don't be selfish. Don't be selfish.
Selfish. Please, skate instructor.
We're talking about candy. I love candy. All right, candy is like fuel, man. You gotta eat as much of that candy as you can, and you gotta get energized. You know what's nice about candy day? I mean, Halloween, is that it's only a week away from National Go Skate Day. That is true. Don't look it up. So basically, Halloween is just a period where you can get candy, fuel up for an entire week, and then go out and skate, and everyone will love you because you'll have so much energy.
Thank you. You seem to be twitching a little over there, but we'll move on. Overly optimistic friend, what do we do with this candy?
Yeah, well, you know, I mean, in the next few weeks, I mean, what's going to happen? You know, you got the asteroid, you got the virus, and you got the zombies. See, you want to put it in a place where you can get it. And you'll be able to. You know, I mean, I have faith in you. You'll be able to find a nice place. You put it in your closet. You put it in your bedroom. You put it in the bunker located 3 stories under your house. You know, I mean, there you never run out of places to hide the candy. But, you know, I just a suggestion, just from a friend. It's very important to have that place because, I mean, the disaster is coming. We all know it's coming. You know, we're not going to... You're not going to be able to go to the supermarket.
Well, thank you so much, Overly. Yeah. We don't have to go into the supermarket and whatnot, but thank you. We have time for one more question. You seem like another person who needs a lot of help. Yes, you. Oh, is it broken or is it just out of charge? Phone is broken. How did they get it working again? Waitress Bess?
Honey? I have a question for you first. Why do you think I have time to talk about your phone? I have 10 tables over there who need me to talk about their food, ask what the specials are. I can't even remember what soup. What soup? Tell me why. No, answer really quick. Why did you think I should know about your phone? Please. Selfish. Selfish.
Selfish.
Selfish. You know who might know about who might be able to help you? Huh? Your friend. He's always hopeful. I don't have time to be hopeful anymore. 10 tables and soup.
Selfish.
Selfish.
Librarian?
Who needs a phone when you have books? Am I right? Yeah. A cracked screen means nothing. Nothing. You open a book. You could play a game in a book. Picture books. That's like a game. Reading books.
Selfish. Coach?
Phones are a distraction. What you should be doing is pumping iron, okay? I want you to go outside, you know, drop your phone in cement. You know what you should be dropping on the cement? Dead weights, okay? I want you to go down here, bah! Right on the cement. You're going to get huge for football season, and we're going to need you a linebacker. A linebacker got hurt, you know, his kneecap went flying into a jar of pickles. He's out for the season. It's not good. It's not good. Doesn't look pretty.
Sorry to hear that, coach. Yes, skate instructor.
All right, you broke your phone. It's no big deal. I do that all the time. You know, I pop a little bonus and it just slips right out of my pocket. Cement, I get that. Cement is very unforgiving to phones, I've found. I've broken like, probably like 40 in the past couple months. Maybe just keep your phone in your bag next time and then it won't fall out. And then just put your bag to the side and hope nobody steals it, you know? That's my best advice.
Last piece of advice here, overly optimistic friend.
You know, I mean, you broke your phone. You know, the world's gonna break soon. It doesn't really matter. You know, you got the librarian over here. Some people lucky enough to get holed up in a library for the next couple of weeks. You know, you'll be able to read a book. There's no power grid. You know, no cell towers. You know, in the cliched words of someone older than me, just go outside, right? You know?
And scene. Thank you so much. We hope we helped you with all that advice from everything, including your problems and your problems. Thank you so much. Well, things are getting set up over here. I would also, this is a surprise, big announcement. Next week, same bat time, same live stream channel. Milkmen will go at it again. The Corpsing Cup 2-0-2-0. Bird and Horgan have been going at it tooth and nail. They've been yelling at each other in the hallways. We will have the Corpsing Cup again for you. This year, a rematch of last year, 5v5. The Milkies look friendly tonight, but it will be a different story on Thursday. Tensions are running high.
Next up, we have a lovely octet singing Hallelujah. Enjoy.
I've heard there was that thing.
I didn't give a reference pitch.
I heard there was a secret chord that David played, and it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do you?
kitchen chair. She broke your throne and she cut your hair. And from your lips she drew the
tried to touch. I've told the truth. I didn't come to fool you. And even though it all went wrong, I'll stand before the Lord of Song with nothing on my tongue but
supposed to be at all. I don't have the answers, not today. It's like nothing makes the questions go away. What I'd give to see if the grass was greener on the other side of all of had and lost. Would it be enough? Or would I still be wondering if I could go back and change the past? Be a little braver than I had and bet against the odds. Would it still be lost? Even if I woke up in my dreams, would there still be something I'm missing? If I had the best thing that I had, I said too much to ever take it back. Scared I'll never find something as good. Would I even know it if I could? On the other side of all of had and lost, would it be enough? Or would I still be wondering if I could go back? Change the past, be a little braver than I had, and bet against the odds. Would I still be lost? Even if I woke up in my dreams, would there still be something I'm missing? If I had everything, would it mean anything? Maybe I should turn around and take the other road. Maybe I'm just looking for what I already know. Could go back and change the past, be a little braver than I had, and bet against the odds, would I still be lost? Even if I woke up in my dreams, would there still be something I'm missing? If I had everything, would it mean anything to me?
I know your expectations of me have been a little higher, but what am I supposed to do? I wanna make you happy, but if I end up lost, what's the cost? And ooh, what am I supposed to do? Smart school is hard, and I know in my heart that I'm far from a star, but I want to keep entertaining you. I know that I've been lucky to have the people who surround me. I want to fly too close to the sun, but they have kept me grounded. But I don't want to stay here, want to spread my wings and fly. I think it's time. What am I supposed to do? Should I try or despise all my time till I die? Don't know why I'm so tied to making my decision based on you. And it's an important decision, trying to figure what you're sent here to do. But I don't think it all needs to come to fruition, and honestly, I've got nothing to lose. Ooh, I know what I gotta do. Take it slow and I'll grow, overthrow my ego, 'cause I know that I owe all my accomplishments to you.
Next is our very own senior players leader, Bess Hughes, dancing to a song that her sister choreographed called Change.
This moment changes everything. Strangers form your skeleton. See the bones glow as they break free. This moment changes everything. This moment changes everything.
so everything we could be.
I've done a lot of things that I'm not proud of. Things that if you'd been around, I know would make you sad. I've been a selfish person, one who gave up and never saw the things that I still had. All I wanted was to see you every day since you were gone. But now if I turn and look, I know I won't go. So let memories stay memories, kept safe inside my heart. For 10 years late, I finally think I know. It's time to say goodbye. It's time to start to try. For who I've been is not who I should be. It's time to do what's right instead of choose to hide. From this day, I promise I will try and see if I can be someone you'd be proud of. Someone you'd be proud of. I never thought that I'd do something special. If something needed saving, I was not the one you'd pick. But now this place needs something like a hero, and there's no one here but me. I never can go backwards and undo the past. The only moment I can change is this one. There's no one left to follow and no arms to break a fall. Yet for once though I may fail, I swear I won't run. But I'm a little scared. I wish I was braver here. Still, this time I won't give in. It's time that I believe, accept I can achieve. And if I fail, at least I gave it all. It's time to choose what's right instead of choose to hide. Maybe I can't change the world, but I can try and do my best to be someone you'd be proud of. Someone you'd be proud of.
Not going to be doing A Mess to Be Made. I'm going to be doing a song that I wrote called I Must Be Moving On. I feel okay for now.
run away, don't run away. Well, I can't cause I don't know how. But I must be moving on. Something is coming in my future. I check the date on the calendar on the wall. I see the box that I'm looking for. It's getting awfully close to the ones that I've checked off. How do I know when I'm ready to make that step, skip a jump, a giant leap? It's not about the cash or the money. I just feel they might think I'm a freak. Must be moving on. Don't you worry, you're not crazy. I say to the mirror when I get up every morn. Because I'm so far gone, making friends with the people in my head is just easier for me. Plus, I'll never feel alone, 'cause I've got me to keep me company. I must be moving on.
We may not yet have reached our glory, but I will gladly join the fight. 'Cause when our children tell their story, they'll tell the story of tonight. They'll tell the story of tonight. Tonight.
Have you ever felt like nobody was there? Have you ever felt forgotten in the middle of nowhere? Have you ever felt like you could disappear? Like you could fall and no one would hear?
Well, let that lonely feeling wash away.
All we need is love.
Maybe there's a reason to believe you'll be okay.
For
'cause when you don't feel strong enough to stand, you can reach out your hand. And oh,
raise a glass to freedom. Something they can never take away.
Oh,
no matter what they tell you,
someone will come running to take you.
Raise a glass to all of us. Tomorrow there'll be more of us. Telling the story of tonight.
Out of the shadows, the morning
we'll tell
is
the story of
and
tonight.
All is
time. Even when the dark comes crashing through, when you need a friend to carry you, when you're broken on the ground, you will be found. So let the sun come streaming in, cause you'll reach up and you'll rise again. If you only look around, you will be found.
And when our children tell their stories,
you will be found.
They'll tell the story of tonight.
Whoa.
No matter what they tell you,
tomorrow there'll be more of us
telling the story of tonight.
The story of tonight.
My name is Taylor April, and I'm going to be singing one of my college audition songs, and I have my first audition this weekend, so why not get the jitters out of the way now? That's all.
Back and unseen, if I long for fire, must it stay unreal? Can I not desire? Am I not to feel? If I ache to taste, am I not to try? If my heart says sail, why should I have my dreams, I have made plans, I see horizons wide as a man's. Will I be nothing till I'm some man's wife? Look at this face, does it deceive? Do I look made to milk and to weave? I will be damned to hell if that is my life. Your age, I'm your match in size. I'm as skilled with swords and equal in most eyes. But when you have a dream and you're caught in its grip, you can climb aboard a ship. You can, for you're a man. You can reach toward that place where the earth meets the sky. Fight a battle, be brave, be true. If you can do it, why not I? I'm meant to fly, sail unrestrained. Why is man free and woman chained? Is that my epitaph? Before I die, I should be free, free to be grace. So I can feel the wind on my face. And when life beckons, I should go face up the storm, not stay below. Am I to be just woman? No, not I.
Thank you.
Wonderfully done. Wonderfully done, Taylor. We have one more Milkman game for you right now. It's going to feature all the Milkies, and it's called My Movie, My Movie. And if you could you be so kind, Cece? We heard your Cece from earlier, yes? Last name? Costa? Fantastic. Could you go into your phone for a second for us and find the last individual or two, one of the last few individuals you sent a text to, and tell us their first and last initial. T-A is great. That's great. T-A, T-A. We're going to play a little game called My Movie with T-A, and we need your help to get this started. We need you to chant My Movie, My Movie, My Movie, all 600 of you on the count of three. One, two, three. My Movie, My Movie, My Movie. We're going to hear those movie titles with T-A. Listen carefully. T-A.
Tall Acrobats.
Tall Acrobats.
Talk a lot.
Tiny Ape Man.
Tiny Ape Man.
The Apple.
The Apple.
Terraforming Arkansas.
Terraforming? All right. Arkansas, you say? All right. Which of those sounds most of interest? I know they're all popular movies that are coming out. Which one sounds, though, the most interesting to you, Cece? Terraforming Arkansas? Fantastic. Please, for those of us out there who don't know, please give us the 30-second pitch of this movie. And I need your help again. On the count of three, you're going to say, let's hear that pitch. One, two, three.
Let's hear that pitch.
Of course, it's about this young couple who have just moved to Arkansas, but as soon as they like bought their house and actually put down the payment, they heard from their neighbors that they're terraforming the entire state of Arkansas away. They're just getting rid of it. So these people have no idea what to do. They just bought a really nice house in Arkansas, and that's the main conflict of the film. And all their family lives in the city, in, you know, Wisconsin.
The city of Wisconsin?
Yeah.
Fantastic. All right, well, we're going to give you a little preview of this movie right now, and I need you to say on three, let's see that movie. One, two, three,
let's see that movie.
Once upon a time, a woman wearing a white cap and her husband wearing a suit said to one another, hey, wouldn't it be great to buy a house in Arkansas?
Hey, wouldn't it be great to buy a house in Arkansas?
I've just always wanted to live in a state that starts with an A.
I know, right? And Alabama's out of the question.
Oh, no, there's too many A's in that one.
There's too many.
At that moment, a man in a sweatshirt came with an ominous warning stating, you best be careful of moving there.
You best be careful of moving there. There's many ants and how many craters down there.
Why would there be craters?
So what are you trying to tell me? You looking for the real estate market in Arkansas? You looking to steal our house, huh? Looking to steal our house, buddy?
Heed my warning. If you don't listen to me now, you will regret it.
You're a little late, buddy. I already bought the house. I was feeling ambitious.
With that ominous warning in the back of their minds, it's moving day in Arkansas. The movers, I guess they didn't hire movers. They're moving the boxes on their own. But the neighbors from next door come in with more ominous news.
Hello? Come in. Are you okay?
Oh, I don't think that's a good sign.
You have a weird doorbell. This keeps knocking.
Yeah, we haven't got it fixed yet, but thank you for knocking.
Try it again. All right, that sounds normal to me.
Yeah, I don't get it.
Maybe in Wisconsin. Yeah, not in Arkansas. You're in Arkansas.
The city, not to be confused with the state.
Here in Arkansas, we don't like newbies around here.
Listen, you better not be dissing Arkansas.
With an
right?
accent that was very distinguishable. At that moment, nighttime entered. And in their home, more ominous things happened. Things that would terraform the entire house.
Whoa.
Honey, where'd the bathroom go?
I didn't look if they had one. I'm sorry.
At that moment, the white-haired woman gets on the phone with the real estate agent, upset that this home that once had a bathroom upon purchase no longer does.
All right. I just called the real estate agent. She said she would settle and give us 50 grand for the bathroom.
Less.
Less? Okay, I'll call her back.
Things in Arkansas worked very weirdly in terms of mortgages and negotiations. It was more a complaint, but now I think they're getting paid for a restroom.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Did you just feel that earthquake? I didn't think those were supposed to happen in Arkansas.
Yeah, we're out of earthquake season, so I can't.
At that moment, the man in the suit comes out of his house screaming for someone to explain. A passerby walking a dog explains about what's happening with this very bizarre city.
Hey, dog man.
What's the issue?
What's going on? We got the thing shaking. Is this supposed to happen down here? We got some crazy tectonic plate action moving around.
You moved to Arkansas. What did you expect?
Oh, the dog's still knocking. You know?
There's
yeah,
not
I
even
know what's
a
going
fault
on.
Line under Arkansas.
Are you dissing my dog? You know what?
Click clack sounds are being made. Dogs are talking. Masks are being ripped off. Luckily, there's a second one. And all of this is happening, and they're starting to reevaluate their life choice. Maybe this move was not the best decision. The husband and wife reconsider.
Right. I know that I was a little too ambitious.
Watch the door. Watch the door. Continue.
Watch. Okay. But I just thought that Arkansas was a nice state. You know, I wanted to move here and get a nice house and start a family.
At that moment, in the background on their TV that was on, the mayor makes a statement that the entire city / state is going to be terraformed.
It has come to my conclusion.
I think that's the mayor.
That the entire city / state is going to be terraformed.
They gasp in awe of this announcement, seeing as though they spent an undetermined amount of money but must be $50,000 or more on this home.
We spent $51,000 on this home. What are we going to do?
We got a barter for him.
At that moment, they have an idea, a brilliant idea, much like that of the Grinch.
I've got it. We'll move to California. There's no earthquakes there.
No, they have a second thought. Not California. Something state-like, but also city-like in nature.
Oklahoma City, does that make sense?
Not that one.
I have a really good idea. New York, New York.
But at that moment, they realized all of those sounded awful. There was only one city-state they could move to. On the count of three, they said it together. One, two, three.
Wisconsin!
Yes, we'll move back to Wisconsin.
One of them's cap was so tight, the response was a little delayed. But they said it together anyway.
All right, let's get out of here before the rest
of the state. We'll move back to Wisconsin. You know what? Yeah. The kids will meet their grandparents. It's like,
in an epilogue of sorts.
All right, back in Wisconsin.
Welcome.
Mom. Hello.
Hey, son. Welcome.
Other mom.
Welcome.
Buddy.
Hey, how's it going?
And it was all a dream. And scene. Thank you so much. We're Milkman Improv. That was my movie. We will send it over to Bess and Shannon with Mr. C and the other senior leaders for final words. Maybe just the senior leaders.
Thank you guys so much all for coming tonight. It took us a lot of effort to put this together, especially with what's happening in the school. We had to plan it last minute, and we're very thankful that you guys were all so flexible, starting it at 4:00 instead of 7:00.
It's so wonderful that we have this group of people who, even through everything that's going on, will still come here and have a great spirit and share their talents with everybody, and it's just so great.
Yeah, I hope you enjoyed everybody's performances. I know I did. I had a great time. It was really fun for me. Everybody did a really great job. Thank you so much for watching on live stream or coming in the first place.
And yeah, that's pretty much it. Everyone said everything, so I just wanted to say thank you.
Oh, one more thanks to Anthony up in the booth. Without him, we wouldn't be able to put on the show. He's what makes us shine down here and make sure we have all of our music. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And another big round of applause for everybody who performed tonight.
Yes. Thank you to Mr. C.
Yeah. I was.